In late 2014, I, along with a team of scientists from the Department of Ornithology at the American Museum of Natural History, went to Vanuatu on the Constantine S. Niarchos Expedition. Vanuatu is in the South Pacific. It's northeast of Australia. There's 82 some islands in the nation. These are relatively small islands that are mainly covered in tropical rainforests. The major threats that the birds of Vanuatu faced are agriculture, invasive species such as rats, and human-induced climate change. So given these threats, there could be many changes to the bird diversity on Vanuatu since early AM&H expeditions. So some 90 years ago, the museum participated in a biodiversity inventory of Vanuatu, collecting birds from many of the islands and doing a lot of the groundwork and baseline work to have an understanding of what birds were found on each of the islands. So one of our goals was to go back and resurvey these islands to see if we see any changes in the diversity between 100 years ago and today. The team consisted of Mike Andersen, Bill Mauck, Lily Fatal, and myself.
I study island biogeography and specifically birds that live in the South Pacific Islands. We're literally walking in the footsteps of the Whitney South Seas Expedition from almost 100 years ago. Getting to resurvey some of these places, both on the ground, in the field, and then taking theories sort of to the next level with all of the DNA work that we're able to do now is really, really something special.
For each bird that we catch, we record information on its natural history, and this includes whether it's male or female, whether it's in breeding condition or not, and whether it's molting. We also collect a genetic sample. For the birds that we could not collect in our nets, we were also recording whether they were present or not in the forest.
Vanuatu allows us to look at patterns of evolutionary history within a relatively small island archipelago, but it fits into a really nice, broad puzzle of the entire South Pacific.
Birds can colonize Vanuatu either from other islands or they can come from the mainland, such as Australia. And after they arrive in the archipelago, they start moving between islands. And when they move between islands, they become isolated. And this process can give rise to new bird diversity. A goal of our expedition was to do a general inventory of the birds of Vanuatu. But we're also very interested in the endemic birds of the islands. And these are birds that are found nowhere else in the world. And some examples of this are the Vanuatu kingfisher, the Vanuatu honeyeater, and the Vanuatu megapode.
One bird in particular is the Vanuatu whistler in the genus Pachycephala. This is a bird that is part of a large complex of whistlers throughout the Pacific. Places like Fiji, there are really dramatic plumage differences from one island to the next. But what's interesting is that we don't see that pattern in Vanuatu. The whistlers there all look the same, and so this is sort of an opposite example of how birds can colonize islands and then seemingly not really differentiate from one to the next.
The majority of specimens collected on this expedition will go to Mike's ongoing work on the evolutionary history on the birds of the South Pacific. We have some ideas about the overall species diversity on the islands and their relationships with birds from different regions such as Papua New Guinea and Australia, but the timing and the processes that led to the assembly of the birds of Vanuatu is still really poorly known. The specimens collected in this expedition will be used in ongoing genetic studies, studies on the physical appearance of birds, and for reasons we haven't even discovered yet. We're hoping this DNA sequence data will help clarify the evolutionary history of the birds of the region.